Hey all, here OS Reviews. You're watching our throwback review of the Sony Walkman W202, also known as the W series. This is actually a generation of interesting headphones that Sony still produces today, but this was one of the earliest models that they came out with, released in 2009. That means this model is now a decade old, which is crazy because the design is still relatively modern looking. This neckband style of Bluetooth headsets, which have become very popular over the past few years, Sony really started the trend again almost 10 years ago. So in terms of features, what makes it interesting is it's actually a digital music player. It's an MP3 player instead of being only headphones. It doesn't have any Bluetooth functionality, but instead it has 2 gigs of built-in storage that you could sync up with a computer with songs, and then it has headphones that are basically integrated, which you would then listen to music with. The best thing about the W series was it was really affordable. It sold for $69 at the time, and for a Walkman that was pretty cheap, also with this innovative design. Battery lasted up to 12 hours, and these were meant for going to the gym. They also had an interesting 3-minute charge, giving you 90 minutes of audio playback. So this is an early form of quick charging. But what was unique back then was a feature called Zap-In. Since this thing doesn't have a built-in display, obviously you can't read song titles from it like you would on another MP3 player. So what it does is intelligently playback the chorus of each song for about 5 to 10 seconds for you to identify it, and if you want to listen to it, you can press down, otherwise you can very quickly navigate around. So the final thing that makes the W series interesting, at least this first generation W202, is it came with a charging stand or a cradle that says Sony on it, and you can use this for charging and for syncing information with a computer. It's an accessory that we no longer see bundled with the latest generation of Sony's W series players, just like the original iPhones came with a charging cradle that we no longer see from Apple iPhones today. The charging animation is also pretty cool. There's a pretty futuristic looking LED light strip which gently glows, and it will keep on flashing until battery reaches 100%, as you can see there on the face. And that's the kind of status indicator light. If we kind of dim the lights here, it's a little bit easier to actually see. The surface of the W202 is made out of a brushed aluminum, and it's held together using magnets. Also cool is the magnets are acting as a power key. So if you take the left and the right apart, the magnets are separated. That's how the player turns on automatically. And when you stick the two ends together again, it automatically turns off. The overall shape of the headphones kind of forms this heart with the cables here, which looks kind of interesting. We just have the Sony Walkman logo on the right. And otherwise, if we kind of unbind it, you can see we have these really delicate chamfered edges, and the magnets inside is how it is able to stick together like so. Now on the bottom is where we have all of the controls, and that includes the aforementioned mini USB, which is being used for charging on the dock here. And we also have the aforementioned kind of scroll wheel, which is very intuitive. You can simply press down on it to play and pause your music, or you can slide to the right or to the left to skip tracks forward or backwards. It's very easy to use. There's also small volume controls here, which you can tap on to turn it up and turn it down. It takes a few moments to get used to, but overall the controls themselves are actually pretty ergonomic once you are wearing them like headphones and putting these into your ears. The actual headphones themselves, as you can see, have an elevated angle to them, so they are also fairly ergonomic. And splitting them apart, looking on the back here, is where we can also see a shuffle key. So by default, the songs on this player are sorted alphabetically from A to Z, but if you turn on the shuffle, it will randomize the songs on the player. And that's pretty much it. They have quite a few spare silicone tips that you get in the packaging to get a very comfortable fit, and as a whole, these are actually very comfortable headphones. They stayed put into my ears. I tried moving around, kind of jogging around with them, and they still stayed in place very nicely. Audio is surprisingly loud and clear, and with a good amount of bass as well. Even after all these years listening to it, I was quite impressed, considering again the relatively low price that these were being offered at. It doesn't offer as much detail or fidelity as on more expensive headphones that you'll find on the market, but keeping in mind these are just regular MP3 tracks, overall you'll still get fairly impressive audio quality, allowing you to just enjoy the music pretty seamlessly. Now back in the day, these headphones also came in a pink variant, also sold at the same price, in addition to this black version that you see here. And again, once you're done, simply snap the two parts together again using magnets, and it automatically turns off. So that's pretty much it as far as just a throwback look at the Sony Walkman W202, the start of the Walkman W series, this very interesting neckband style headphone slash MP3 player combination from Sony. And for me, it's kind of a reminder of the golden days of Sony, where this Japanese manufacturer really dominated in terms of electronics and sales. Their computers, headphones, players were all extremely interesting, very much innovative. And even looking back, you can see many of these features that are still very much relevant today. So you can check out more details about this player in the links down below and the current generation of Sony's Walkman W series. But for now, that's been our video. Thanks for watching here at OS Reviews. That's been a revisited, kind of throwback review of the Sony Walkman W202.